Kaif has been called upon to play a couple useful hands already in this series. A match-winning one at Sabina Park. One that ultimately fell short in St. Kitts. And he's come in at the fall of his captain, Rahul Dravid. Forced away square. That's a good way to get off the mark. Right out of the middle of the bat. To end over number 16, the 50 is up 51 for 3. Beautiful stroke by Mohammad Kaif. Dwayne Smith having no chance, playing it on the up, square on the offside.
Nice timing. Kaif has come in right away. Just started to time the ball sweetly, a lovely front foot square drive for four off Cullamore to begin with. Just a little push into the offside. Good save, brilliant. Dwayne Bravo. Short enough to give him the opportunity to cut away for four. Kaif has come in and made such a difference. From the very start, that square cut off Cullamore got him going.
There is protection in the deep. And Mohammad Kaif finds the gap to perfection. Not the easiest shot to play, but he does it well.
Yeah, it was a very good shot considering the ball didn't bounce. It was quite short. And it hassled him a bit, didn't it? Just swiveled around and helped it on its way. Just didn't bounce, did it?
Again, it could be tight. He was run out in the last match. Mohammad Kaif. The three runouts in the Indian team, and this would have been very tight had it been a direct hit.
I get the feeling it might have been out. Lara pounces on it, one stump really to look at, and I feel that ball's past the stumps there, and I feel he would have been out. Big dive. Oh, bad luck, skipper.
He's certainly seeing it well, is Mohammad Kaif. Another important innings for the Indians. Getting it away fine for four. You think someone like Mohammad Kaif will have to be there for at least the next 10 or so.
Well, I think Dhoni's crucial. I really do. And I think it's almost stating the obvious because of his ability to score at a strike rate of well over 100 runs per 100 balls.
They push easily for the second. Athletic Bravo messing up there, and gifting Kaif with a second run that brings up his 50. And that's a well-worked half century for Mohammad Kaif, 50 number 17 for the determined right-hander. Just short of the bowler. Maybe you could sense that urgency now.
It's not an easy pitch on which to play his strokes. I think it's been evident throughout the day. has been turned. It's been a little bit too pace. There have been deliveries that have bounced a little unpredictably. Have to work really hard on this surface. That's why you're not looking for 270 or 280.
And dropped. Straightforward catch. Put down by Marlon Samuel that he can't believe that it happened. It was almost too easy.
Oh, it was just a lob. Almost snatched at it with pretty hard hands.
And Kaif will want to make him pay. And it's been put away down behind square. Inappropriate way to end what has been a tremendous spell by Samuels. A boundary finishes it off. It's 178 for four. And almost invariably he starts with a slow ball. The return is on the way. And it's a good one. Got the impression that Kaif has made it.
Well, not very often. You see Simon Toffel going for the third umpire. That was a terrific job. Was that a direct hit? I think Mohammad Kaif, which is home, just not collected the ball, Carlton ball. He should be home.
Steve Butler will press the green light, which he does now. Good strong return from Sam Mills, probably the strongest arm in the West Indies team. But Kaif is very quick between the wickets. A chip. Improvisation by Kaif. Gains him two more.
They've got to be innovative. They're consistently right into the block hole, the West Indian bowlers. For the third time, he's getting into the 60s in the series, Mohammad Kaif.
Stump. A good innings for Mohammad Kaif comes to an end. 62 for him, it's 188.